even though we are here as a spiritual being, we are stuck working with this physical animal body. It's an animal body because it really is born, it's going to die, it is driven by hormones, it is totally, especially on this planet, jerked around by the emotional body. We are going through a lot in what we do with the emotions and the way they especially manipulate our behavior. And here we are, spiritual beings that are working with this physical body and trying to make sense of how do we understand it and not be totally driven by it, but bring in the higher aspects of who we truly are. So we live in a three-dimensional reality. That means we have an x-axis, a y-axis, and a z-axis. So three different axes in this reality that determine a three-dimensional form. So a man in a book, let's give him credit for having some consciousness. So a man in a book has only two dimensions, which means that when he turns sideways, he disappears because he doesn't have any other dimension. He's only got this one-dimensional reality. And so if we wanted to communicate with him, we might do something like draw a two-dimensional form, such as a circle. So when we draw that in his reality, it's 2D, what does he see? He just sees a line. So out of frustration, we might draw a triangle. You know? And again, the only thing he sees is a line. Another try, and a square also becomes a line. I've read some things where they talk about Flatland and they say, oh, the little man that lives in Flatland, if you give him a sphere, as the sphere goes down through his reality, he sees a small circle and then a bigger circle and then a small circle again. But no, he doesn't. Only thing he ever sees is a line. But we see the circle because we exist in a dimension higher up. You see, all these different dimensions that I was pointing out earlier, one is a subset of the other. So the fifth dimension incorporates the fourth dimension, incorporates the third and the second. And so here we are in the third dimension, and we have the second dimension down pat. We know what a square and a triangle and whatever else I drew up there looks like. You know? But the 2D man doesn't. So that means, you know, there's a very important thing to understand here is that the only way we can fully understand who we are and what's going on in this dimension is to start to operate from a higher dimensional part of our being. This is what some of the different things we're going through today in working with spiritual evolution are all about. How do we move ourselves not out of this reality, but how do we move ourselves to a higher aspect of reality so we can look back and even have some more control about what this character is doing here now, about what's really going on now in this reality.